Scott Anderson, pinch hitting today for Carrie from Valley View Farms. He's here to answer your plant and gardening questions. How are you today?
Good. How are you?
Good. Good to see you. All right. So a lot of people are ready to plant, even though the temperatures might not quite be there yet, but you brought something to get you started.
Yeah. Last weekend, there was a lot of people excited when the temperatures almost in 60 degrees.
Yeah.
And everybody, first thing they always want to do is put their tomatoes out. The only thing you can really do right now with the temperatures we're having in the frost is start everything inside.
Okay.
So what I brought with me from the Jiffy Company is a little kit. These are little pellets that are compressed peat moss.
Mm-hmm.
You add water to this whole system. They'll actually expand to about that size. You add, take your seeds, put 3 seeds in each one of these holes, take the cover, cover it, and keep it warm, and you'll actually have germination, depending on what type of seed, in probably about 10 days.
Planting made easy.
There you go.
Love
and just
it.
Pop these right in the ground.
Great idea. Thanks, Scott.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get to some questions. We'll start with this one. I have 2 pecan trees from North Carolina. The pecans form but are not ripe or complete. What can I do for them to produce edible nuts?
Depending on the fertilization and also how old the trees are, I'd probably ask them first how long they've been in the ground.
Yeah.
It does take usually about 3 years for a tree to mature to want to produce fruit.
Mm-hmm.
And also what kind of fertilizer they're giving it and when. But pecans are not usually an easier one to grow.
Yeah, okay. Here's another one about a tree. Would it be possible to grow an olive tree in Baltimore? My yard gets at least 8 hours of sun a day. Would you recommend a specific type?
Olive trees you can do,
mm-hmm.
But you must treat them like a tropical, like a hibiscus. They cannot get cold weather, no frost, and here in Baltimore you can keep them outside during the summertime, but in the fall they must come inside.
Okay. This one, real quick, I purchased a cut flower called Kangaroo Tail. Can you tell me which country it's coming from and if it's possible to grow in the Maryland area? They have yellow or maroon blooms with a furry exterior. Does that ring a bell?
I've never heard of a kangaroo plant.
Okay.
But if you want to call the store, talk
send
to either
picture.
Carrie or one of the ladies. They can even email a picture to Carrie
okay.
at carrie@valleyviewfarms.com, and we can figure it out, I'm sure.
Excellent. Thanks so much, Scott. Great
You're welcome.
To see you.
Thank you.